if you're planning to get into medical school and you are confused about all this, you don't really know, you've gone through different sources on the internet, suddenly if you've entered medical school, your first day, and you don't fully understand, then this is the right video and keep watching. We're going to talk about first year. If you guys watched my last two videos, I'll put the link down in the description box. I talked about medical school. I generalized everything. Like I called first year, second year, third year. Like I just made summaries about them. But I want to make segments of that video. So this time I'm going to be talking about first year medical school, at least in Nigeria, and everything. I already have everything prepared. This is my school handbook. It will be helping us today. It is going to be like serve as a guide for what I'm going to tell you guys. They gave this to us when I got into medicine first year. During our orientation, they shared it with us, our faculty handbook, and it's beautiful. Like it contains everything. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. So I have like different topics I want to talk about. First off, let me answer everybody's question. My name is Winny. I am currently in third level medical school. I'm going to be talking about subjects. There's no other way around it. The honest truth is that you have to study. You have to study as hard as you can. You have to be like, you know, read. Because if it's really what you really want, for whatever reason it may be, study as hard as you can. Because medical school is not like a walk in the park. Although, if you read, if you play your cards right, if you're consistent and diligent, you can make it. And with God by your side, you can make it. You can achieve almost anything. You can achieve everything that you want. My advice, if you're planning to enter medical school, I know some, you know, this strike and then this lockdown crisis that went on this year, I'm sure that some of you are at home, and you know, 8 months is a long time. At least I've stayed home for 8 months. I can't even believe it's 8 months. But the courses you're going to take in JAMB, if you're preparing for medical school, are English, Physics, Chemistry, and Biology, and they are so important. So you need them. In WAEC, you take, I think, nine subjects in your WAEC, but the core courses for medical school are Physics, Chemistry, Maths, English, and Biology. These 5 courses. And I have Economics, but I don't know. Always have these 5 courses in mind when you're writing your WAEC, and then those 4 courses in mind when you're writing your JAMB, because they are all important. My first day after I got into medical school, I was really happy. I thank the Lord for helping me. And when I got there, it was truly different, because in Nigeria, you don't go to, like, I know that overseas, I did some research and I found that overseas, you have to go to college, maybe go to med school for 4 years plus residency and fellowship. I don't know how many years you stay in college, but in Nigeria you study medicine for 6 years and your residency and fellowship combined. I'm gonna give you guys the tips that I wish I knew before I entered medical school. First of all, the subjects, I think you're going to stay, there are 2 semesters, because university is so different. I'm talking about in Nigeria. Universities are so different from high school, secondary school. They're very different. In secondary school, you get like 3 terms in university, you only get 2 semesters in a year, in a session. So when I got into first year, they divided our courses into first year and first semester and second semester. They were the same, but it was like second semester was the continuation of first semester. And you can also notice that change in the course codes. And then I found out that they used the credit unit system. Now each course you do in the university has its own credit unit. And whatever score you get, there's a whole formula for you to get your GPA, and there's a whole range of, and from your GPA that you find out your class of degree. The first year we were doing general courses, like general science courses with other, like biochem, physiology, anatomy. We are doing everything in first year, you know, since you're doing courses with other people and all that. You have not started doing your medical school like courses properly. So for you to cross over to second year, from first year to second year, they use the grading system, the CGPA grading system. So I might show you guys the table on the screen. So for first class, 4.5 to 5.0, that's first class. Then second class upper, we have 3.5 to 4.49, that's second class upper. Then we have 2.4 to 3.4, that's second class lower. We have 1.5 to 2.39, that's third class. And then we have less than 1.5 is fail. So that's what the grading system that we are using in first year. When we cross over to second year, it wasn't like that. In medical school, we don't have that kind of, we don't use that method of grading system. It's either A, distinctions, B, like that. So that's what we use. We don't use this anymore, but we use it in first year. So the courses, I'm going to get right down into the courses. The courses we used, we studied in first year. Okay, it's a long list, a very long list. So the subjects we did, the courses we did in first semester, we did Bio 101. It's like general biology, the advanced stage, you know, biology that you did in your secondary school, you know, you'll be learning the advanced version in university. We now have Bio 107. That's 107 is stand. Once you hear 107, it stands for practical. Yes, it stands for practical, because all the courses that have 107 are mainly practicals. So we have Bio 107, that's biology practical. You practice whatever you have learned, like they are simultaneous. Whatever you learn in Bio 101, you practicalize it in Bio 107. We have Chem 101, that's general chemistry. It's just chemistry, the secondary school, the advanced stage. Then we have Chem 107. Like I said, 107 stands for practical. So it's basically chemistry practical. And whatever you learned in Chem 101, that's the general in chemistry, practicalize it in Chem 107. Then we have Physics 101 and Physics 107. General physics and practical physics. Then Math 101 was general mathematics part 1. So the math in university, I think I said that in my last two videos. Mathematics in the mathematics we were learning is further math, secondary school. Like, further math is the foundation of the math we were learning, because they were advanced, and I didn't do further math in secondary school. I didn't want to, because I heard it was so hard, so I didn't do it. But you can actually succeed, you can actually pass, because if you have good lecturers, you're going to pass it. Like, I love my maths lecturer. He was my best lecturer in my 100 level. Like, he made sure that we learned everything, taught us over, like, we didn't miss anything. Then we have CSE 101, that's computer science. You learn computer science, you know, You cannot do it with that computer. This is like technology age. You can't do it with that computer. And then we now have GST courses. GST stands for General Studies. So it's like basically General Studies. So GST 101 was use of English. It's just English language in a different fancier name. Then GST 103 was use of library and study skills. You know, they were teaching us how to behave in the library, the library's book arrangement in library system, how to study, all these kind of stuff. They were really helpful skills. They were really helpful topics, and they even taught us like reading methods and all that. It was really amazing. The topics were, the course was really, really great, and it was amazing, but the workload was much because there was too much notes in that one, but it really helped. It was, this is one of the reasons why it's good to teach this kind of courses. GST 105 was Nigerian people and culture in Nigeria. You have to learn about Nigeria. So that's what we're doing. We are learning about Nigerian, how Benin, Igbo. I don't know how I did that. I just like read it like a novel, wrote the exams, and don't do what I did, please. Don't do what I did. It's not good. You have to study everything. Study, learn it, work hard at it, no matter what, no matter how useless you think it may be. No knowledge is a waste. Honestly, I can tell you, no knowledge is a waste. But I thank God I learned it. There are some things that I learned in this Nigerian people and culture that I didn't really like. I wasn't really exposed to, but now I learned, I studied it, like social studies. But you are learning about Nigeria proper, like history, going back to how we started for second semester courses. Like I said, I don't know if it's like that, but I just want to call second semester courses. Second semester courses, we also did GST courses, that's the general study courses, but they were not the same. We did GST 102, that's use of English part 2, that's like continuation of the English we were learning in first semester. Second semester courses were like continuation of some of the courses we did in first semester, so that's how we continued. It was like from English part 2, GST 104. Sorry, philosophy and logic. It wasn't really how to explain how it helped us, but I just know that knowledge is a waste. Then we now had GST 108. That's history and philosophy of science. Sorry, that's what we did. Then we did GST 106. That's peace and conflict resolution. We did bio 102. That's general biology. Anyway, just the continuation of what we did in first semester, that's bio 101. This is just the part 2. Then we have bio 108, that's like practical. We have chem 102, we have general chemistry, and chem 108, that's practical chemistry part 2. That's basically a continuation of chem 101 and chem 107. Then we have physics 102 and physics 108, that's continuation of general physics and practical physics, like in first semester. Then we now have math 102, that's general mathematics part 2 courses each semester, and we used the GPA grading system and the CGPA grading system. And CGPA stands for cumulative grade point average, and it is derived from dividing the total point for all the semester by the total credit unit. Okay, let's just say you have a table, like it's shown here. You have a table here, and this is all the courses that we did in first semester. Let me just give an example of CGPA. This is the courses that we did in first semester, and these are its credit units. Use of English has 2 credit units. Use of library, 2 credit units. GST 105, 2 credit units. Bio 101, 3 credit units. Bio 107, 1 credit unit. All the practicals had 1 credit unit. Then bio chem 101 has 3 credit units. Then physics 101 has 3 credit units. Maths and CSC has 3 credit units, and that's like the same thing in the second semester. All the GST courses had 2 credit units, and then the general courses, like the general biology, general chemistry, general physics, they had 3 credit units. Then but then the practicals of these courses had 1 credit unit. So in total for that semester, you get the total of the first semester credit units of all the courses you did are total is 24, and that's just what they are telling you. And GPA is when you divide your like what you got, the total of what you got in all those courses. And from the CGPA you get your class of degree. I also did some research for other on other universities abroad overseas. So they basically do med school. They have college separate, then they go to med school for 4 years, then residency and fellowship. And the courses they do, they start directly, they start by learning basic human physiology, histology, anatomy and biochemistry. These are the courses that we're going to do in 200 level medical school in Nigeria. So that summarizes everything that I have on first year. It's not much, but I hope it's going to satisfy you guys and teach you guys. And I hope this video was helpful. And if you liked it, then click the subscribe button down below. Click the thumbs up button if you liked this video and taught you some things. And press the notification bell so you get notified anytime I post. I post every week. So that's the end of the video.